pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing. Please remain standing. Moment of silence for the sick, handicapped, departed military, departed military, this community, and also let's please recognize our veterans that serve our country this week. Thank you very much. Roll call, please.
Mike Palmer?
Here.
Bruce Valdez?
Here.
Nina Petruzzelli?
Yes.
Jason Zarate?
Here.
Bill Corrigan?
Here.
Bill Henderson?
Here.
Joe Ryan?
Here.
Mayor Pat Lazio?
Here.
Solicitor Thomas McDermott?
Here.
Engineer Bill Sykes?
Here.
Borough Manager Lori Holland? Here. Sergeant Williams?
Sorry, Williams.
Already?
Here.
Zumberg, UMass, DMR.
He was here. I think he's in the restroom.
Is there the visitor? Thank you very much. All right.
Hi, I'm Stacy Ryback. I am with Senator-elect Guy Reschenthaler's office, and he was supposed to be here tonight and got called to an emergency meeting in Harrisburg, so asked me to come on his behalf to say he's excited to be sworn into office soon and to work with your community, and knows he got a lot of support here, and we're open for business, and give our office a call. Same number as Senator Smith's office was. We'll take over that space and that number. So we don't have cards yet. Ink wouldn't be dry, but we're here to serve you. If there's anything we can do, we're happy to help in any way. So.
Thank you.
Thanks for having me. I got another meeting to run to on his behalf, but we look forward to working with you.
Thank you very
much.
Richard Bryan?
Yeah. Since I was here 6 months ago, I just want to let you know that, there's still, and I am working with the Boys and Girls Club on this, of Carnegie, and they did the typing, and this is a new collaboration, so that, wasn't the best we could have done, but the corrections will be made. But the content is there. When I hiked to Harrisburg in June, I was here in May, exactly 6 months. I talked to people along the way, and I didn't actually intend to do that, but I did. And we started talking about the veterans. People stopped, they honked, they fed me, they let me sleep in their businesses or homes. I took a tent, but these ideas, these people really believe in this. This our Western Pennsylvania people. And I never even had to open my tent. Now this went on for a while to get to Harrisburg. So I broke down in Chambersburg, and then I said, look, I got to go to the Capitol with this. So. I did meet with Ortite, the Chief of Staff for Caden McGinty, and Governor Wolf. So people really like this idea. It's not me, it's the people of Western Pennsylvania. So anyways, I just want you to keep in mind, 22 suicides a day by our veterans, okay? Now, in the 6 months since I've been here, that adds up to 3,965 veterans, okay? Tony Lobianco, he's the actor. He doesn't do a lot of acting now. He's now a playwright and poet. I think he hit it with the best. he was on the tube about it last week, and he said, it's immoral that this is happening. My word would be Holocaust. So As you can see, these by those 4 points, and there are so many mistakes, and I do apologize for that, but we'll get it straight. Like I said, it's the content that is important, not the verbiage, okay? And that's what I'm going to be doing is to collect money for the Boys and Girls Club. 100% will go to our veterans, to the Boys and Girls Clubs to help our veterans, I should say that. And ultimately, I could go through the points, but they're right there. And I've been told that, or advised that the best thing is to get a resolution. Just a resolution. I mean, sure, it'd be great if you gave me a check for $300 to sponsor a kid. How do you want his money, thoughts, and be a sponsor? But more important than that is the resolution. Because it's Western Pennsylvanians, why not start it here in Bridgeville? Bridgeville's the town of bridges, but we can maybe go into the city of veterans, you know, of and for veterans. So,
When you came in May,
yeah.
You were asking to continue the walk and have it either begin or terminate here in Bridgeville.
Mm-hmm. I didn't walk back to Bridgeville. I just walked there as far back.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
You, this would be the point, and
yeah,
I think that there was started. I think that there was some reception for that. Here, wasn't there?
We talked about it.
I felt good about leaving here, Bridgeville. I'm still relatively new to Bridgeville.
If I remember correctly, I mean, I know it was right before Memorial Day we were here.
Yeah, exactly. And I started.
It was exactly. Kind of thrown on us. I think as far as what was required from us,
nothing.
You know, we didn't know. Yeah.
It was simply a warm reception.
Right.
And that this is something that the community,
right.
That we wanted them to start this march.
Right. That you needed to know, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you can let us know when the date is and stuff and see if we can coordinate something.
Yeah, if you let us know, we'll facilitate.
Well, the resolution is all I need now. If I could get that.
So when is the resolution?
What's that?
You want a resolution supporting your 4 points on the,
yes.
On the paper.
Yes, so I can take that to Harrisburg. And the Boys and Girls Club. I want, I'm raising money for the Boys and Girls Club so that we can do this together.
Right.
It's a symbiotic relationship, similar to people and their pets, especially dogs. But veterans and kids, we can get this done. It's really a true symbiotic relationship. I know I missed some things. I couldn't write. I have tremors. And the other thing is, if you know somebody that can type, I will pay them. Whatever the rate is, I will pay out of my own pocket. This will not come out of the Boys and Girls Club. But as you can see, there were several mistakes. So if you have any questions about it, which you probably do, I'll try and shore that up. But
I think we need, I don't think we could, I think there's something we need to sit down away from the meeting and go over and see what type of resolution we need to come up with instead of.
I think you should I think you should leave it to the legal person here for this resolution to put in such a way that that would be compatible to what he wants.
Right, exactly.
And we are supported, no question about it.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, we want to divide ourselves in some, I can't find the proper term, financially or thing like that. The lawyer already understands, I'm sure, when I can't find the proper term. But
have you been in front of other bodies who have actually had
this is the first one. Okay. This is where I live, and I figure I'll start here at first. Like you did first to get in $300 because you're going to get the credit, for that. And like I said, going to the Boys and Girls Club for a trip to Harrisburg, which is a learning experience for them, okay? And as a former teacher and coach, I you know, it's a good education.
We work on the resolution and, you know, we work on that, and then we'll be putting it in the next meeting to get a vote on.
Okay.
Does that sound right? I mean.
Well, I was hoping to get started, basically going from business to business on Washington from South Fayette to the Boys and Girls Club in Carnegie. And having people post this resolution letter. Mm-hmm. And it's a must. Yes.
If you
not going to homes now. No homes, just businesses.
I don't even know that we, for businesses, do we even need a solicitation permit?
Not normally.
No. So you, most I don't know if there's don't. Anything required yeah. from council for yeah. you to do that mm-hmm. tomorrow morning.
You do that
morning.
Anyway.
You don't need okay. a resolution to do that.
You can formally, you can say,
yeah.
someday soon,
yeah,
the in writing, the government of Bridgeville yeah. will support you, but
yeah.
pretty much the council of Bridgeville, the government of Bridgeville, is in favor
yeah.
of this concept. Yeah. You can say that, way. But right now, as the chairman okay. told you and the lawyer told you, this would have to
okay.
be drawn the proper way.
Okay.
And if I might ask you, I get your 4 points of life for veterans. Are you're asking Bridgeville Council to support what, federal or state legislation?
This is actually federal legislation.
It's
so ultimately, these kids will have to go to Washington, D.C.
A
resolution
is there a piece of legislation that you want them to support?
Yeah, this.
So do you want? Do you want? Is there already a piece of legislation out there?
No, this is from the people of West Virginia. When I walked across the state, I saw the people, and these are the four main points. Of course, there were other things that they wanted to get done. That's why I stressed the point that they were so adamant about this. I never had to open my sleeping bag. I opened my sleeping bag, but never my tent. I never had to open my tent.
Have you gone to any legislators to ask them to
I'm going to go see Mike Doyle, and I'm going to go see Tim Murphy. These people were advised to go see, because
right.
When I went to Fortenay's office, McGinty's and Wolf's in Harrisburg, they said these people, and somebody from Chester, Pennsylvania, Farrar, he's in charge of Veterans Affairs. And then I talked to a lot of people, and this is what they want.
And I guess my suggestion would be that if the board was going to be asked to support a piece of legislation, that you kind of get it to the point where there actually is, if I can finish the legislation, because I think in concept, I guess under these points, you're asking for support for some legislation, federal legislation that would.
No.
Or some legislation that
no,
would.
No, it's not legislation.
Or this
support
for the concept.
Right.
But where. But the proposition is that there should be somewhere legislation that would provide all veterans the same medical card and care as congressmen, that current VA hospitals would be used for short and long-term stays, that there will be established, I guess, family support centers for spousal jobs and emotional support and special boarding schools, etc., and that every young adult will have to give 2 years of service either to service to America, Peace Corps, etc.
Did everybody get that? Is it okay if I ask for a raise of hands of people who would support that?
Jamie,
you want to read it again?
No, my question is, I guess, what is the nature of what
not,
they're being asked to support? Legislation?
It's a resolution. This is not, you're not supporting any legislation.
But
this has to go through Washington.
I understand that, but I'm trying to get an understanding of what you want these folks to support. Is it that you want them to support the proposition that there should be legislation that has these points in there, that this should be the law?
Ultimately, yeah. You people agree with that, or am I barking up a wrong tree?
I'm not expressing a statement of agreement or disagreement. I'm simply trying to understand what you're asking here. Let me see if I can bridge the gap between the legal aspects of a resolution by a governmental agency and what you're asking for, which is a show of support for an activity.
Yes.
Okay?
Exactly.
And I think we have support for the activity that you are coming forth with. I don't know that a resolution is necessary. I think that that's not necessary.
Support is okay.
Our support we have. Okay. You've got our support.
I never passed or tried to pass a law or resolution or anything in my life. And I'm pretty sure the Boys and Girls Club of America, Carnegie, never passed a law either.
And it's a fine charitable organization which is registered with the state of Pennsylvania and what it's doing.
Yeah. Are there any other questions?
No.
Thanks.
We will be there starting around 9:45, 9:30 Friday morning. I'm leaving about 4 Friday afternoon so people from Furry Friends can come down and buy. But it's Friday and Saturday, so we expect to see you all walk in and eat things and buy things, and then we go on the diet. Also, I want to mention that we are going to have another raffle. And this time it's going to be 2 tickets to a Penguin hockey game on the 18th of December. And we will have those tickets. I'm picking them up Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We'll have them here Friday. That's money raisers. The program for the end of this month is Tuesday the 24th. The man presenting it is from the Sheriff of Allegheny County office. His name is Jason Tarrick. And for those of you who live in Mill Street, Main Street area, his grandparents live there. That's when I met them, getting absentee ballot stuff from them about 25 years ago. Anyway, he's a very good speaker. It's on how not to be a victim during the holidays, especially when you go shopping. So send your family, you come. Starts at 7:30, Tuesday night, the 24th. 2 things for me personally, okay? Just strictly personal thoughts that sometimes get a little action going. On election day, outside the poll, I found a woman who echoed something that I believe in. And she asked me about it, how I felt, and we realized we both were aiming for the same thing. We feel, and this is half a joke and half serious, we feel that PennDOT owes Bridgeville a lot. And in paying us back for some of that, helping us, we should have a toll booth 1 month a year, every entrance into Bridgeville. PennDOT would make a lot of money, Bridgeville would make a lot of money. But it's just the point that we feel that PennDOT does owe us some kindness. So what are your thoughts, maybe 5-10 years now, you'll have?
Can I interrupt you at that point? Mr. Solicitor?
No, it's not legal.
On Bower Hill Road, our road?
Can't put it on legal.
Show me the law that says you can't on Bower Hill Road.
Okay, I'll research that.
Thank you.
Mary's been trying to get that done since...
I understand on Pendott Roads.
About 5 years ago, so...
Yeah.
But we have, you have resolved to send it to Pendott. But Bower Hill Road, from McLaughlin to Washington Avenue, remains our responsibility. And I would love to see a toll booth on that. Not 1 month out of the year, but all 12. You know what, we give them Christmas off.
I'm suspecting that because you don't see toll booths all over the state on local roads, it's probably an obstacle.
I'm thinking you're right, but I have yet to find the chapter and verse that says it.
Thank you. The other thing that I've run into was a serious complaint about eminent domain. I'm not sure that this person was telling me all the truth or just one side of the truth or what, but eminent domain came to her mother's house, and with no witnesses, she was threatened. Therefore, if PennDOT, or no, scratch that, that's not bad. If eminent domain is that serious, then the legislature of the state of Pennsylvania should consider putting in a 25-year era after eminent domain, and they have the actual amount of money they want to spend on that piece of property. They should be paying the municipality tax, the school tax, and the county tax for 25 years. Then they'd all have to learn to get really creative. But anyway, these are thoughts that I've had, and I'm sure people out there agree with me and some don't, and I don't care. I'm not running for office anymore. But I want to thank everyone who listens to me. And more importantly, I hope you get active in the Historic Society, because it's a great, come and see the oldest telephone I've ever seen in my life. We had to have a wall built to put it on. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Reverend Samuel Dunmore?
Business owners need to hold up their end of the deal of cleaning their properties. Or, there's a lot of young people that are running to, after the gazebo, with a lot of free time on their hands. And I'm going to start an organization soon, have a paperwork in my bag. I would like to see these young people be paid to do the job that is not being done, to give them some motivation and an early start on employment. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Bob Fryer.
Thank you. Give me a moment. In the past few weeks or days, some things have come up related to the solution that you're all working on about the traffic congestion. A member of a state legislator told me just a few days ago that Mount Lebanon and Upper St. Clair have reenacting their attempt to lobby, put another interchange by 79 to West End Forest Road, and create a major corridor to get I-79 consumer motorists around the Southfield Bridgeville business districts over Route 19. I think I just wanted to show you this. This is a drawing that I made several years ago. Excuse me, coming your way. But this was the result of a Route 50 corridor commission plan that was started years ago. And it wasn't started by the people in Route 50. It was started and instigated by the Mount Lebanon and Upper St. Clair business district leaders and officials. But there's Bridgeville, and there's Safayette. That's Boyce Road, and this is the Painter's Run Road. And there has been a formal proposal that was made several years ago, and within the last 5 years, this Painter's Run proposal, which would be connect the current ICE exit on I-79 to Painter's Run Road, again, it would draw I-79 consumer motorists from going through the Collier Bridgeville Southfield Business District over to their business districts in Upper St. Clair and Mount Lebanon. And why that's important now is I also understand that there's, I'm sure you've been told, I guess in the next couple of weeks they're going to have another task force meeting. And I just wanted to remind you again that this is the present task force plan that they, or this is, well, you want to hire?
Yes, please.
Yeah. And this is the present task force plan. When I say present, this was the version in June of this last year. I think I brought it to your attention before, and you said it's modifiable and it can be changed. But I just want to mention again, this plan. That's Chartier Street, for those of you who are far away. This is the Bridgeville Charter, or the Chartier Street by the Bethany Church, and this is New Route 50 and so on. This part of the plan, it will essentially not do much at all for the traffic on North South Washington Pike, Washington Avenue through Southgate and Bridgeville. It's primarily designed, where the red line arrows are shown to you, it's primarily designed to get to add another lane on Chartier Street.
Not a lane on track, just a stacking lane.
Yeah, left turn stacking.
That's been said before. Everybody thinks we're going to put two lane, a lane
all the way up.
All
the way up. No, yeah, let's make that very clear. Yeah. It's only going to be for like 100 yards right. from the railroad bridge down. And there's been false rumors about that. But from the railroad bridge down, that's very important, though, because that allows 40-plus cars to go move down to Washington Avenue, take a left across the bridge at the same time, and take a right on New Route 50, and then disperse wherever they want to get.
Right.
It's very critical. However, the red arrows show that most of the traffic relief is going to be east and west, primarily between I-79, and certainly Bridgeville people use Chartier Street, but it's about 75% of St. Clair and Bethel Park residents that use that corridor. I'm more interested in the green arrows. If you can see, there's only one green arrow going in each direction between Bridgeville and Safayette.
That's exactly what that's designed for.
Yes, that's exactly right.
I mean, that's what we want to get that bottleneck out of there.
Yeah, I agree. But let me mention this, and you've heard me say this informally before. Excuse me. This design, there's this church again, and the bridge. This bridge should be seven lanes, and incidentally, in the traffic force plan, they have adopted that seven lanes.
Yes, seven lanes.
That's wonderful, because you build a bridge about every 75 or 100 years, so that's a key component. However, what needs to be done is that plan has to be expanded so that it benefits Bridgeville's people and business districts and Safayette's people and business district. You have to have two through lanes moving in both directions between those two business districts, and that includes, or that doesn't include, the left turn stacking lanes. For example, right now, if you see what the left turn into Aldi's store does to the people in Bridgeville. Right now, you see, because there's no less stacking lane in front of Bethany Church. And it's relatively simple to accomplish that. And you don't have to encourage, again, please don't carry away the false rumor that it's necessary to encroach on Bethany Church's property. That doesn't have to be done. The only modification necessary is, you see this little dotted line? That's where the curb is, right now in front of that, wherever that drugstore is down there. By just moving that curb line over 12 feet and let it go from there on an angle to zero to James Street, that allows you to put a left turn stacking lane right there. So the people that want to turn left off of Washington Avenue up Tertiary Street won't again congest the traffic in Bridgeville. But the reason, and I don't want to get into details, but essentially, this four through lane thing goes all the way up to, you know, where the traffic light is by Getco, the Neil Drive. And I might mention this, and I think Joe Sykes already knows this. Remember when Mike Haberman was down here, and that's the traffic engineer that Joe works with? I met with him for a half hour, showed him this plan. He agreed. He also agreed with the recommendation, or it was his recommendation. He said, from keeping running four lanes to the traffic light going down Dual Hill Drive right there is a great idea. But he said the road shouldn't be narrowed to two lanes and then widened out to three lanes and you get to the left turn into Burska. He recommended that from the traffic light to the Burska left turn, it remain consistent three lines. So what I'm asking you is, if Borough Council and Soffitt's commissioners, let's take a stand, I don't know if you're quite courageous or not, you've got to make it clear you want the whole thing, not just...
I understand, Bob. And like I said, we've had this conversation before. we will mention it to Soffitt when we talk to him about the two lanes. Unfortunately for us, that's Soffitt, that's not Bridgeville. And I know you say you got to go to the boardroom, hey, you got to push it.
Yeah, you're
right. We'll talk to them, but I would recommend that you go to their meetings.
I will.
And as far as on Washington with the left-hand turn going up Chartiers,
right.
You know, that's something we can look at. That's ours.
No.
You know, that's our town. No.
Mike,
15 years.
Mike, let me just mention one other thing. It's a detail, but you guys have got to know this stuff. Why, that left turn stacking lane, that left turn stacking lane that was created in front of Bethany Church lines up perfectly with the left turn stacking lane that's supposed to go into Albies, and it won't tie the traffic up. Now, one final thing.
Sure.
Several months ago, I discussed this briefly before. She is in favor of it, of course. But she said the same thing you just said to me. That's primarily a Sophia Township issue, and they have to decide that. That's not exactly true. Matter of fact, in the Pennsylvania Municipalities Planning Code, section 408, it says this very specifically. Notice to other municipalities. This section requires a review of any official map or amendment in an adjacent municipality, so the map will show streets, etc. Number two, furnishing a certified copy to the adjacent communities. And the purpose of it is to make sure the communities, the adjacent communities, have full knowledge.
Right.
So you not only have the right to tell Soffitt what you want, you have an obligation to do so, and then the law will back you.
All right, okay. Thanks, Paul. Hey, Paul, one last thing. You mentioned right at your start, that you talked to a legislator about an exit from Upper St. Clair, Mount Lebanon.
Yeah.
I don't need to look at that. Do you know who that name is? Who it was? Could you give me the name?
Yeah, I'll tell you that.
I'm interested in checking on that.
Yeah, no, I'll
we can see what he
said. I'll wait.
No problem.
It was a staff member.
All right, that's fine.
Yeah,
thanks
for
your interest. Bob, are you saying you're in favor of this first point? I didn't get the finalization on you. Are you in favor of that or are you against that?
Against this, are you kidding me?
It wasn't clear from your comments.
I'll tell you what, that's what you just don't want. I'll tell you what's going on here. 90% of the money spent on a road is political. And Mount Lebanon and Upper St. Clair are spectacular communities that have enormously influential lobbyists. we can't let that happen. You've got to maintain the north south.
But did you want to speak? I mean, you signed in.
Yeah, because.
Yeah, I mean, you got anything you want to say?
I don't. Just,
okay, that's fine. No problem. Not a problem. Just, and Lisa, you signed in.
You're going to miss me. I'm
sorry. All right, that's it. Move on to the regular meeting. Minutes. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of October 12, 2015, the workshop meeting as submitted.
So we have, we did all three.
Motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of the October 12, 2015, public hearing as submitted. And a motion of the Borough Council regarding the minutes of October 12, 2015, regular meeting as submitted. Bruce and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Conditional use application, Shoes 2 LLC, 112 Washington Avenue. Conditional use application has been submitted by Shoes 2 LLC to the property located at 112 Washington Avenue. The property owner intends to conduct a vehicle rental sales and service on this property, which is a conditional use in the B business zoning district subject to zoning ordinance chapter 27903.39. The applicant has met all requirements set forth in the ordinance with the planning commission engineer sites recommending consideration of the application by council. Public hearing to receive citizens' comments was conducted on November 9, 2015 at 6:30 p.m.
I so moved.
I second.
Nino and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Proposed ordinance number 904, zoning ordinance update has been tabled. Proposed ordinance number 985, the motion of the Borough Council authorizing Manager Collins to advertise proposed ordinance 985, an ordinance of the Borough of Bridgeville relative to the establishment and maintenance of police employees' pension, annuity insurance, and benefit funds or funds to amend certain provisions of the pension plan or program applicable to police of said borough to comply with the Internal Revenue Code of 1986. This ordinance is required conditioned upon the favorable determination letter issued by the IRS for the new police pension plan.
Second.
Bruce and Jason, all those opposed? I mean, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Washington Avenue 6 corridor signal timing and phasing updates. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the work authorization submitted by the Gateway Engineers in the amount of $10,000 for traffic engineering services to adjust the signal phasing and timing along Washington Avenue between Station Street and Presley Road. PennDOT requires this work to be completed prior to the adjustment to the signal phasing in aforementioned areas.
I so moved.
Second.
Nino and Jason, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
No.
Right, motion carries. Current estimate number 2015 pavement maintenance program. Motion of the Borough Council regarding the remittal of current estimate number 1 2015 pavement maintenance program to El Grande Industry Incorporated in the amount of $134,710.27 for work completed today. Estimate has been reviewed by engineer sites.
I make a motion.
Bruce?
Second.
Is that Bill?
Yeah.
And then Bill Anderson? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Current estimate number 1, 2015 line contract B. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the remittal of current estimate number one, 2015 line contract B to Jet Jack Incorporated in the amount of $25,858.98 for work completed to date. Estimate has been reviewed by engineer Sykes.
I shall move.
Bill Calusi and Nina. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Calendar year 2016 budget workshop advertisement. A motion of the Borough Council authorizing Manager Collins to advertise a budget workshop meeting to be held on Tuesday, November 17th, 2015 at 6 p.m. Make a motion. Bruce?
Second.
And Nino? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
Just noting this is at 6 p.m.
6 p.m.
7.
That's what I said, didn't I?
Yes, you did. I just wanted to remind you, you normally meet at 7.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I have just been caught by that before.
Gotcha, no problem.
For you, it's 7.
7 o'clock. calendar year 2016 proposed budget advertisement. Motion of the Borough Council authorizing Manager Collins to advertise the calendar year 2016 proposed budget to be available for public inspection on Monday, November 23rd, 2015. This advertisement will meet and exceed the 10 days public review requirement per the Borough Code.
So moved.
Bruce and Nina. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Resolution number 2015-10. A motion of the Borough Council regarding the resolution number 2015-10, a resolution authorizing the Borough to enter into an interim consent order in agreement with the Allegheny County Health Department concerning alleged sanitary sewer overflow related to the Borough's sanitary sewer system and to authorize the proper officers of the Borough of Bridgeville to execute the interim consent order in agreement.
So moved.
Nino?
Second.
And Bill Henderson? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Bill list. Motion of the Borough Council approving the 2015 bill list.
So moved.
Bruce?
Second.
And Jason? All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Payroll, motion of the Borough Council approving the payrolls of November 13, 20, 27, and December 4th and 11th of 2015.
Make a move.
Jason and Bruce. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports. Motion to accept the payment commissions due the October 2015 real estate tax collector report. A motion to accept the September 2015 financial report, and a motion to accept October 2015 police report, and a motion to accept the October 2015 zoning report.
So moved.
Second. Bruce?
Nina?
Or Neil?
Neil.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Committee reports. Bruce, administration.
No report, sir.
All right. Thank you. Finance, Nino.
Thank you. General funding, $1,595,434.59. Sewer fund, $324,402.62. Garbage fund, $21,425. Payroll, $2,226.89. Capital improvement, $25,118.26. Liquid fuel, $174,087.96. And we are within the budget. Thank you.
Thank you, Nina. Parks and Recreation, Jason.
One thing, folks coming to an end here, you ready to shut the water off. Luckily, we've had a little bit of nice weather, but for probably a week or so, we're going to be
15 or 11?
We have, I actually sent the letter into them to shove it off anytime this week. Beagle had their last match, I think, on Saturday, Athletic Association staff.
That's it.
All right, thank you. Public Works, Bill Clucy.
Yeah, they're going to start on Borough Hill Road's wall this week, and all that, so that's a big start.
Good. Excellent, that's it? All right, thanks. Public Safety, Bill Henderson.
Yeah, I got a couple of things. We continue to negotiate with the police department, we're hoping to bring that process to a closure quickly. The committee met and we discussed a concept and we want to share it with you guys. We're currently reviewing Chapter 15 of the Borough ordinances, and we're going to continue to hold some discussions over the next several months in an effort to kind of identify old and antiquated and unenforceable ordinances that are in the borough currently. And the first part of 2016, we'd like to bring this all to some conclusion and make some recommendations at one time, some changes that we see need in the community. I'd like to extend that to all the members up here. If there's anything you see out there in Chapter 15 that you'd like us to consider, please bring it to our attention in the committee, and we'll certainly do that. The last thing I have is Officer, I was going to call him Sergeant, but he was promoted. He stepped out. Officer Roman Williams has successfully completed his one-year probationary period. His date was November 2nd, 2015, his anniversary date, and through the recommendation of the Chief of Police and the Mayor, I would like to make a motion to hire him full-time as a full-time officer, having successfully completed his.
I second the motion.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed? Congratulations.
Congratulations.
No, we had some discussions about, there's some things we talked about in the past that haven't completely been completed, so we're working on that right now. Probably injured some of that every morning.
Thanks. Mr. Mayor.
Well, I think we have finally given shoots to permission to open an auto sales facility. It has taken, how many months, Lori?
Probably three or four months.
I think it goes back to somewhere around February when you started to look at this.
Well, but that doesn't start at all the applications.
Right. Long time. Long time.
So what's the point?
The point is that the impediments. If you want to encourage people to do things in this community, you need to make the process a little bit easier. That is not a comment on any of our borough staff who do their best in a very difficult zoning ordinance. My hope is that both of the zoning ordinance changes will move forward at the next meeting, and that there are other changes that we could put into it that would, again, make it easier. Do we really, really need to go through an entire conditional use process for some of the items that are listed for conditional use? We have three auto sales places in Bridgeville. Do we really need this to be a conditional use in our business district? We didn't seem to have any big issues with shoots too. We have small ones, we have big ones. Why is this a conditional use? Why is it that you have zoning restrictions on design standards that you are not necessarily wanting to be followed, but sit in our zoning law? So these are areas where you, where I would hope that council would consider making things smoother and easier. Because if you want people coming into the community and develop here, making your zoning law more friendly is a way of doing it. And that's not to say everybody can do just whatever they want. That's not the idea here. The other, another piece is that we really do need to support the South End. And I know that I don't think anyone here opposes it, moving on the South End. So. And then that, I'm happy to see Officer Williams finish his probationary period.
Quick year, it seems.
Time does move quickly. It does move quickly, and light-up night will be coming very soon. Hope to see everyone there.
Thanks, Pat. Solicitor.
I have nothing to add to my written report, Senator.
Thank you. Engineer Sykes.
Thank you, Mr. President. Most of my items have been addressed with agenda items. I will say the CD42 grant for the demolition of 781 Mile Hill Road is going to be submitted this week to the Southwest COG. An update on the Route 50 Task Force. There has not been any meeting. I think we're still waiting for the state budget to be passed before PennDOT can move forward with any of the items that they have funding that are linked to the budget. And as Lori said, we have a meeting next week with PennDOT and the water company regarding the replacement of the main water line on Washington Avenue prior to doing the resurfacing project. And we're going to look at our sanitary sewers and see if there's any repairs that are necessary to conduct at the same time.
Thank you very much. Fire Chief Bill Julio.
Thanks, Mr. President. Guys, our report for the last 2 months, nothing's fixed in the computer end of it. Just to let everybody know, a couple things. Last week, kind of busy for us. We had a little fire up on the avenue, one at Unique Auto. And then we also, a day later, we assisted crafting on that fire down in their crafting towers on that Sunday. So, I mean, we go as far as there to help each other out. And one other thing I have is October, the last Monday in October was our last bingo we had at the fire department. We shut it down. Just nobody, not getting enough people in, we were in the hole. We've been in the hole for a little while, and it was time. So, we had a nice turnout for the last one, it was kind of funny. You know, we had 124 people show up for the last one. You know, we were getting 60 for the last couple of months. So it was kind of interesting how many you say the last one, they all show up. But, so, but yeah, that's no longer going on.
Everybody,
I said that to them. You should see the votes I got. Let them where I keep going until we had nobody coming again and they all give me looks.
How was the comedy club turnout?
Very nice.
See that?
Very nice. Quick report on it. We had a lot of people really enjoyed it, so we'll be doing it in the fall. Just because the fire department got rid of that doesn't mean we're getting rid of everything else. You know, we're losing money there, but the fish fries will be here, the cash bash will still be here, and the comedy night in the fall is going to be another thing. So we still have the other things. That's all. Just let everybody know. And thank you.
No problem. Thank you. Dan's left.
Yeah, he had to go on a call.
All right. We'll catch you next time. Library, Dr. Whitney.
Hi, good evening. I hope we saved some goodness for last. I am the president of the Bridgeville Public Library Board of Trustees, and I just wanted to just give you a little bit of information. Funding for the Bridgeville Public Library, we received Pennsylvania state funding through a Pennsylvania state library code. And in order for us to be eligible for that state funding, the municipality of which we are a part of, Bridgeville, is expected to contribute $5 per resident of this community of Bridgeville. Through a lot of work and participation with our borough council and Mr. Nino Petroselli, and previously Mary Weise was sitting on council, we are up to about $3.50. And so I would like to just remind you that we're thinking about you. We're currently working on our budget as well. We've been working hard. We have a new board. We have some familiar faces. And with funding to, this kind of funding can help to increase, this will help with our relationship with our school district. We've also added another professional librarian in the library. We have currently a library director, Cheryl Napsha, and a library manager, Ben. And Cheryl's been with us for about a year. We're going to begin book delivery to Homebound and outreach to senior residences like Woodville Manor. And this Thursday evening, November 12th, we're having John Haig speak to anyone who's interested in coming. It's a free opportunity. He was a steward on Air Force One during the administrations of three presidents, and he has written a memoir of his experiences. This has been possible through the assistance of the program coordinator position that's been added. And as you have already heard, I'm sure, and if you haven't heard, we do have a contract for management with South Fayette Public Library. So together we have strengthened the library systems in these communities. And we've probably saved a lot of money. And we've also been able to expand hours so that we have additional hours without spending, putting extra money and burden onto the budget. So we're a very conscientious group, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
Borough manager.
I provided an overview of things that are happening during the month. One of the things that I want to touch on is Congress has notified us that they're ready for the commencement of franchise renewal process also. And as I reported a few months ago, Verizon had done that also. And we collectively do that through the COGS to keep our costs down. So we're trying to see which municipalities Comcast contract is up to and try to have them to come back together. So he specializes in the cable contract. So another thing that I have, we've been working with KMA as far as our assignment goes. And I had a meeting with them regarding construction drawings, just taking a look at the sign heights, making sure they're where they should go. And we had a gentleman confront us as far as an LED Bridgeville Borough sign from 84 Outdoor that I told him that I would let council know about it. I didn't give him an opinion one way or the other. But on the back of my report, you'll see a rendition of the sign that they're proposing. This would be when you're coming, just when you're coming from Collier Township into the borough, really right in front of Ruby's place. But this is a really, really big sign. It's actually one that does not comply with our zoning ordinance, and it would be something that we would not have control of as far as we could put Bridgeville messages on it, but businesses outside of Borough Bridgeville could buy messages and that type of thing on it. And I told them I wasn't sure if council wanted to go in that direction, but I would certainly let you know because they paid for the sign, which is about $150,000 sign. That's with the LED.
The sign that we're proposing doesn't have the LED.
No.
It's not hard. It wouldn't be that much money.
I mean, this thing is 16 feet tall, and I mean it's like a building. And one of the things that I told them was that it was actually too big. It didn't comply with our zoning ordinance. And I had we had someone that wanted to put a sign there prior to the owner shoes. And I had denied it, but I just wanted to let you know that that was out there, but the borough wouldn't have control over other than that, there are a couple things as far as the McLaughlin Run Road parking. We had sent some warning letters, initial letters regarding people blocking sidewalks, and I've been informed by Bill that they're still doing that, so we'll ramp up our letters a little bit and try to get that solved. And the Baldwin Street parking regulations will be advertised and be on the agenda for next month. And one last thing, the Southwest Corridor study.
Joe and I went to that meeting probably February of last year.
March, yeah.
And Kendall had, who's the company that was doing that? I can't remember their name.
Yeah, I can't remember.
Whatever. There's a consulting company that they had doing the South Hills Corridor study, which included the borough of Bridgeville. They contacted me and said they're finally complete, and they're going to give me some dates that everybody can get there. That was at the initial meeting to give us some of their findings, which may help us as far as what we're trying to do with the Kendall study. So, if anybody has any other questions as far as...
You are it.
You are it.
You are it.
I would have never remembered that.
Thank you.
That's all I have to say.
Old business.
Is it new ones that you would have?
New business.
And new business.
And new, like to call an executive session to discuss where we're at with the police contract.
Okay. We're in break for executive session. Free to stick around, because we're gonna come back and then basically here.
Is there any reason we're closing our actual requirement, you know, you can turn it off?
Is there another?
Well, I wouldn't close the meeting.
Yeah.
It's up to you.
I will leave it open just in case.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Do you think that 85 Road is gonna be smaller?
No, that's their...
That's it?
That's what they pitched.
These contract meetings?
So make a motion, we adjourn.
A second.
All right, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those?
Rub, rub, rub.